Hey there, my name's Drew Brashler, and in this video, I want to show you how to use the brand new Behringer P24 system with the hub and the mixers with your Behringer X32. Now, if you're brand new to my channel, I'm all about helping you feel more confident with your production gear no matter where you're starting from. Now, if you are wanting to have a few more audio tips and tricks in your pocket, I have a weekly newsletter over at audiotoolkit.co where I send a weekly tip and trick of one of my favorite things into your inbox for free. So go over to audiotoolkit.co to check that out. But let's go ahead and dive in and see how we can integrate the P24 system with your Behringer X32 or Midas M32. Now, with the P24 hub, we have the ability of feeding AES50 to it. Now, on the front of the P24 hub is a source select button, which allows you to choose between the stage connect, which the X32 does not have, and then AES50 with a 24 channel version and AES50 with a 16 channel version. So the first setup that I'm going to show you is the 16 channel version with the P24 system. Now on the front of your P24 hub, you will want to select the second AES50 option, the AES50 33 through 48, which will give us our 16 channels that will then send to the P24 mixers. Now, I have my AES50B pulled up because my AES50A is where I have my stage box, and then I am connecting my AES50B of my X32 into the input on the AES50 for the P24 hub. Now, I am going to be utilizing 33 through 48 for my sends from my X32 to the P24 system. And I have selected on my routing, go to AES50B, I have selected P16 1 through 8 and P16 9 through 16. This means that anything that I select in my P16 or alternate over here on my P16 setup, any of these 16 channels will then go to the P24 hub and then feed the up to 8 P24 mixers dedicated from the front of the unit. So I have my P24 mixer connected into the front of the P24 hub, and let's go ahead and send some audio to this. Now, I have my oscillator sending some pink noise down my mix bus 1. So we can just test this. So as we're listening into this, we're just listening to some pink noise that I'm going to be pushing through the different outputs. So go back to routing to my P16, and then on my output 1, I'm going to go select mix bus 1. And when I select this, then we will see on fader 1, we have green here. And if I go ahead and turn this up, we will start hearing that in our ears. Now we have the ability of panning this, but this is a mono channel. Because on our number 2, if I go to mix bus 1, we can see that now I have another fader of pink noise, and this is independent of the first channel. So the way that the 16 channel mode works is the first 8 faders are all mono. So I can show that by going to the 3 and selecting mix bus 1. That's now green. 4, mix bus 1. Again, 5, mix bus 1. 6, 7, and 8. And so we can see that all 8 of these channels are green, showing that we're getting audio from the board to these different channels. Now, 9 through 12 convert into stereo channels. And so this is where we can use 9 and 10 as a pair for our fader on 9. So if I was to put mix bus 1 down 9 and then turn this up, we would hear this just on the left. And then if I was to add mix bus 1 on 10, we would then have it stereo. And if I go back to 9 and turn this off, we just have it in the right side because I'm only sending it on 10. And so then our fader 10 starts at 11 and 12. And then fader 11 is then 13 and 14. And then our last channel, channel 12, is 15 and 16. Now, one other cool function of this is that even though this is set to a 16-channel mode, meaning that the first eight are mono and then the last four channels are stereo, we still have two outputs that we can send from our console to the P24 system for our talkback. And that appears right here on this talkback volume section of our P24. Now, if I go to my AES50B, the 25 through 32, the outputs here, the very last two outputs, so 31 and 32, would show up on my talkback here. So let's go ahead and change this to be outputs 1 through 8, so this is easier to route. And I'm going to go to my outputs 1 through 8. And so on my 7, I'm going to pull this from Mixbus 1. And we can now see that on my talkback, I have the pink noise coming through. And if I turn this off, we will hear it go away. And then on 8, I have the same thing. So if I go to Mixbus 1, we also have a talkback here. So we can actually take our talkback mic and send it down 7 or 8, and it will appear on our talkback volume right here. Now, one other cool function is if you're not needing to use the talkback function of the P24 system, you can send your click track and your cue down these two outputs. So output 7 and output 8 would be then going to 31 and 32 on the AES50 lines that are going to the P24 system. And then that sums them into mono and gives us a single fader for adjusting our click track. And then we also have our 8 mono channels and our 4 stereo channels on our P24 system. Now, if I was wanting to configure 12 stereo channels or 24 channels going to the P24 hub and system, then I just need to go change the configuration on the front of the P24 hub to be AS50 25 through 48. So I'm gonna go ahead and do that right now. Give this a second to reconnect. Now that I have that set, I have an additional 8 inputs into the P24 system that have appeared here on 1 through 4. And so now if I go to my AES50B, I'm going to be pulling my outputs 1 through 8 to go through to 25 through 32. I could also additionally choose to use outputs 9 through 16 instead of 1 through 8, but in this case, I'm going to be using 1 through 8 because my 9 through 16 is already going to my DL32 for the output to my PA. So on my output 1 through 8, I have that going to AES50 25 through 32, and I am going to go to my outputs. And on output 1 through 8, this is my first 4 channels. So my output 1, we can get Mixbus 1 going, and there's the left side. And then if I go and add to output 2, add to the right side. And so we can see that outputs 1 and 2 are for the first fader. Then outputs 3 and 4 would be for the second fader. 5 and 6 would be for the third. 7 and 8 would be for the fourth. And then on our fifth fader, this is where we had pulling from our P16. And so on outputs 1 and 2 would be for our channel 5. And we can see that disappear if I go to my 1 and my 2. There we go. So we have the ability of sending 24 channels from our X32 to the P24 system, leaving us with 8 channels of outputs available for sending to a PA or monitors or whatever we need to output from our X32. Now, one additional thing to note is that our talkbacks then move to the last two channels here. So it moves to 23 and 24 for our outputs to come into the talkback input. So if I had this set on outputs 9 through 16, then my last two would go to 23 and 24, which would then be the talkback input into our P24 system. So these are two ways of configuring your Behringer X32 into our P24 hub and getting this system working. Now, if you're interested in using Ultranet for our input, that's going to be on a different video. So keep an eye out for that, for getting your P24 system working with Ultranet as the inputs into the P24 hub. Now, if you do happen to have any questions, or there's a video that you're hoping that I would make on the X32 or the P24, or really any of the other production equipment that's out there, please post that comment in the comment section down below, as I'm always reading through those to find videos that are going to be helpful for you. If you haven't already, make sure to check out my website at drewbrashler.com, where I have a full set of presets and templates for your Behringer X32, your Behringer Wing, or your X-Air series mixers available for purchase and download. Otherwise, I hope you have a great day.